We're asked to fill in the table with the missing function values, then determine if the table models a linear function or an exponential function. Function values with a pattern of repeated addition represent a linear function, and function values with a pattern of repeated multiplication represent an exponential function. So looking at the first table, notice how the inputs or x values are increasing by 2. Now we need to determine the pattern in the function values to determine the missing function values here. And notice how the function values go from 0.5 to 2.5, 2.5 to 12.5. So if we try the pattern of repeated addition, 0.5 plus 2 is equal to 2.5, but 2.5 plus 2 is not equal to 12.5, which means you do not have a pattern of repeated addition. So now let's look for a pattern of repeated multiplication. 0.5 times 5 is equal to 2.5, and 2.5 times 5 is equal to 12.5. And therefore we do have a pattern of repeated multiplication, and therefore we can now determine the missing function values, and we also know that f of x is an exponential function. If we have a hard time determining the pattern of repeated multiplication, to determine the multiplier, also referred to as the growth factor, we can take any function value in the table and divide by the previous function value to determine the multiplier. Notice 2.5 divided by 0.5 equals 5, and 12.5 divided by 2.5 is also equal to 5. So we can always use this to determine a possible multiplier or growth factor. And now to complete the table, 12.5 times 5 is equal to 62.5. 62.5 times 5 equals 312.5. If we wanted to describe the function f of x in words, we could say that f of 0 equals 0.5, and f of x is multiplied by 5 every 2 units. We say every 2 units because notice how the x values or the inputs increase by 2 in our table. Now let's look at the second table. Notice how in this table the x values or inputs are increasing by 1, and now we need to determine a pattern to determine the missing function values. Notice how the function values go from 4 to 1, and then 1 to 1/4. Well, 4 minus 3, or 4 plus negative 3, is equal to positive 1, but positive 1 plus negative 3, or positive 1 minus 3, does not equal 1/4. So again, we do not have a pattern of repeated addition, and therefore we do not have a linear function. So now let's look for a pattern of repeated multiplication. Again, if we have a hard time determining a possible multiplier or growth factor, we can take any function value in the table and divide by the previous function value. For example, if we start with the function value of 1, 1 divided by 4, of course, is equal to 1/4, or 0.25. If we use the function value of 1/4, we would divide by the previous function value of 1, which still gives us 1/4, or 0.25. So this shows that we do have a pattern of repeated multiplication where the multiplier or growth factor is 1/4. So following the pattern of repeated multiplication by 1/4 or 0.25, we can determine the missing function values. 1/4 times 1/4 is 1/16, and 1/16 times 1/4 is equal to 1/64. Because we have a pattern of repeated multiplication, our second table is also an exponential function. To describe g of x in words, we can say that g of 0 is equal to 4, and g of x is multiplied by 1/4 every 1 unit, or every time the input or x value increases by 1. Before we go, let's look at the graph of f of x and g of x on the coordinate plane. So if we were to plot the first three points of f of x on the coordinate plane, we'd have this point, and this point. And notice how if we were to sketch the graph, we have a curve that goes uphill from left to right. And that's because we have an exponential function where the multiplier or growth factor is greater than 1, and we call this exponential growth. If we plot the first three points of g of x on the same coordinate plane, we'd have this point, and this point. Once again, notice how if we were to sketch the graph passing through these three points, we do have a curve, but in this case, the graph goes downhill from left to right, and that's because the growth factor or multiplier is between 0 and 1. In this case, we call this exponential decay. Notice neither graph forms a line, verifying we don't have a linear function. We have exponential functions. I hope you found this helpful.